Buenos días, chicos. ¿Cómo estás? This is Dr. G and Sophie from your Spanish 111 Summer 03 class, as an elementary Spanish 1. Today we are from Cleveland. We left Colombia on Saturday. And this is the plan for the day. Let me see, I'll move it here and share with you my screen. Yeah, that's Sophie. She's gonna be making noises. I cannot control that. If I put her over her tree, she'll make more noises. Okay, this is the plan of the day. During this period, the learning objective is that during this period, you guys will work on learning how to point out people and things to others. The thing is that we are avoiding repetition, see? So we are going to continue with the topic of the family, trying to avoid repetition the same way you do it in English. If you say, "Does she open the door?" you would answer, "Yes, she opens it." See, she opens it. You wouldn't repeat door. You would actually, you wouldn't repeat the whole thing. You would say, "Yes, she does." Okay, but just for the sake of working on the pronoun, which is the topic for today, I wanted to do it that way. Does she open the door? And you answer, "Yes, she opens it." It is the pronoun that helps us avoid repetition in English for objects. Let's see what happens in Spanish. First, I wanted to present the rest of the plan for today. I have something fun for you today on the faith integration part. I will see it in a minute. In the second piece, we are gonna talk about family. We're gonna learn how to make and to extend an invitation. And then we are gonna use two specific verbs that are only one in English, to know, and Spanish has to saber and conocer. Then we have a test, and we start arreglo personal with chapter 5, see? Let's go with this. This is Unción Tropical. It is a group from Puerto Rico. These are two brothers. They work on the music business. And at some point, the Lord touched them, and they decided then to dedicate their lives and their success to praise Him. Look at this song. And the song is, we have Joy in different versions of the different churches, including the Catholic Church version of Joy. The song Joy is in here. Let's rejoice.
Nale, vup! Fala, Edlin, выйти из строя! Остаетесь за старших!
Yo no sé lo que le pasa, pero a mi Señor cambió mi tristeza en baile, me llenó de su alegría. Ahora un hombre nuevo soy, pero mi Señor cambió mi tristeza en baile, me llenó de su alegría. Ahora un hombre nuevo soy. Hay muchos hermanos que no se pueden reír, siempre están enfogonados o tal vez atribulados, pero mi Señor cambió mi tristeza en baile, me llenó de su alegría. Ahora un hombre nuevo soy, pero mi Señor cambió mi tristeza en baile, me llenó de su alegría. Ahora un hombre nuevo soy. Y yo te digo así, si tú tienes gozo, levanta las manos si tienes gozo. Y si tú me amas de verdad, hermano.
My brother.
No cambien la cara y dame la mano.
Talento de las casas, Luis Jan.
Gozo, I wanted joy.
Gozo,
but I was searching for that joy where there was no such a thing. But then Christ, the giver of life, he gave me the joy that I wanted.
Si tú tienes gozo,
canta
este coro si tienes gozo.
I have joy in my soul. They're like rivers of living waters.
Si tú tienes gozo, te lo digo por última vez.
Last time.
Si tú tienes a Cristo, dame dos palmadas. Si tú sientes a Dios, dame tres. Si tú tienes el Espíritu Santo, dame cuatro. Y si tienes el gozo de papá, dame cinco. Ahora yo quiero a todos los cristianos con las manitas. Ahí, ahí, ahí. Eso es con las manitas. Para. Me voy.
On this Monday, chicos, let's rejoice. And let us, God, lift us up in this day, celebrating His creation and the masterpieces that His creations made to praise Him. To Him, all glory and honor. Okay. Let me go with the direct objects, and I'm going to open the textbook for you, chicos. On page 124, we have before direct objects an element that is relevant to direct object, and it's called personal act. See? And for that, I have opened this video that you guys will find really, really a benefit for you.
The personal a indicates that a direct object refers to a specific person. Although there is no equivalent in English, all direct objects that name specific people must be preceded by a in Spanish. If there is more than one direct object naming a specific person, each one is preceded by a personal a. The personal a is not used with direct objects that are things, or with direct objects that refer to unspecified people. The personal a is also omitted after the verb tener.
One thing that happens with the personal a is not included in the textbook, and let me tell you.
The personal a indicates that a direct object refers to a specific person.
Okay, so the personal a refers to a specific person. Yes, the personal a has the power. It's not a preposition. Remember when you say, I'm going to the park, you say voy al parque, and that's a contraction, see? That's not the same one. Well, let me open a new. Voy a la farmacia. See, when you say this, voy a la farmacia, this is not the same one as the one in the personal This one implies, it announces the place where I'm going towards, okay? So, and you know, every single motion, every single verb in Spanish that implies motion towards a target announces that target or place with the preposition a, which is not what we're studying. That's the preposition. We're working on the, working about the personal a. And when you see the sentence, visito tres hermanos, and I know you know the name of this restaurant, right? Visito tres hermanos versus visito a tres hermanos, or visito Colombia, and you know the name of that country, or visito a Colombia, we are saying two different things due to the personal a. This personal a that is in the second sentence transform the subject into human. When you say visito tres hermanos, we are referring to the restaurant. See, visito tres hermanos is the place. See, and it could be the name of an object, but in this case, it happens to be the name of a place. See, restaurante, restaurante. So visito restaurante tres hermanos. Here we would say visito el restaurante tres hermanos for this specific case. Now we omitted the words el restaurante and just left it with the title of the restaurante. It's not human. We don't need the making it human. But when we go with the second sentence, we say visito a tres hermanos. This a personal is making this two words that are the same one on the first one, this human. So this, you are saying, I visit three brothers, I visit three guys that happen to be siblings, okay? So the personal a has the power of making that direct object human. Let's go with the second sentence. If you say visito a Colombia, those are two different sentences. I have a friend whose name is Colombia. So I might end up visiting her, my friend. Same, visito a Colombia. I visit a lady whose name is Colombia. But when I say visito Colombia only, this is not human. See, so the a personal has the power of making the direct object human. If I say visit, oh, it happens also with pets. So if you say visito Sophie, it could be the name of a restaurant too. But if you say visito a Sophie, you might be talking about my parrot. See? So visito a Sophie. So you do it with humans or with animals that happen to be pets. See? That's the difference, and it's not in the in the textbook. Okay. So because of that, I am gonna open here in the assignment. Where did I put that? My calendar for the personal, which I have here, and for the direct object. And I'm gonna assign that now. And I'm gonna show you some personal direct objects. Here we have one. Veo, look at that. You and your friend are relaxing in a cafe, casually sharing memories and ideas. Complete each sentence with your the cue you hear preceding the personal a. So recuerdo mucho
mi abuelo.
Also, you need if it's a person or not, mi abuelo. So he said, mi abuelo, I need the personal a. So necesito mucho a mi abuelo. Got it? Second one.
La clase de arte.
Oh, okay. So recuerdo la clase de arte is not human. So I just say la clase de arte. Got it? Muy bien. Remember, let's see number three.
El italiano.
El italiano.
El francés.
El francés. Ok, comprendo bien el italiano and en francés. These are languages, not people. So we don't need the personal A. If we needed the personal A, each item would need it, okay? So it's not that one personal A covers all the nouns that go after it. No, each one has to have it, okay? Another exercise with personal A is this one. Oh, I click on the same one, chicos. Direct object, personal A. ¿Quién llamo? This is direct object. One thing that I saw that exercise. Let's make visito. Let's make this a question. Visitas a tres hermanos. And I'm gonna make that a question. Visitas a tres hermanos. And I'm gonna remove that. Make it a question. Visitas a tres hermanos. Do you visit three brothers? Then I'm gonna answer sí. That's so. Sí, yo visito a tres hermanos. That is the full answer. If you go for direct object pronoun and replace it with a pronoun, replace three brothers with a pronoun, it's not it, it's they, them. You guys are gonna not use the personal A with the pronoun. Sí, yo, oh, I need the accent mark. Sí, yo los here, yo los visito. Notice that I did not use the personal A right there, okay? So personal A makes the direct object human. The noun that is acting the direct object transforms it into human. It has that power. It's like magic. Okay. Now the next topic that we have to study is direct objects. As our calendar mentions it. See, direct object. We already covered a personal A. So let's go with the direct object. I think I chose one direct object video for you, video tutorial that I wanted you guys to see. I'm gonna choose the English one.
A noun or pronoun functions as an object when it tells who or what the action of the verb affects. A direct object is one that the verb acts on directly. That is, the effect of the action is felt directly by the direct object. We can find the direct object of a sentence by identifying the subject and verb and then asking what or whom after them. In the sentence, Kara threw a ball, we can identify threw as the verb and Kara as the one doing the action, that is, the subject. If we then ask, Kara threw what? The answer is, a ball. The same process works if the direct object is a person. In the sentence, Carla kissed John. We can identify kissed as the verb and Carla as the subject. If we then ask, Carla kissed whom? The answer is, John. Some sentences contain more than one object, but only the one that is directly acted on is a direct object. For example, in the sentence, Kara threw a ball to her sister, there are three nouns. The subject, Kara, and two objects, ball, and sister. The verb in the sentence is through. So to find the direct object, we ask, Kara threw what? The answer is, Kara threw a ball. Ball is the direct object. We know that sister is not a direct object because Kara did not throw her sister.
Okay, there we have our direct objects. So let's play with it a little bit and see what happens. What's going on, Sophie? And see what happens in Espanol. See? As the direct objects or objeto directo are used to avoid repetition. And let's see this question, this text, which is a boring text, see? Por la noche cociné papas fritas, see? Last night, I prepared French fries. Primero lavé las papas. First, I did that. Luego, then, I peeled them. Pelé las papas y corté las papas. Freí, I fried them. Las papas en aceite caliente. Y finalmente puse las papas en un plato. So, papas, 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 papas. We don't speak like that. We avoid repetition. So, let's make this boring text into a fun text. Okay? Okay? So, por la noche cociné las papas. The first time we need to state it because we need to talk. We need to describe what we're talking about. And it needs to be there. So primero, I washed them. First, I washed them. So primero, las lavé. Luego, pelé las papas y corté las papas. Luego, las pelé y las corté. And then I fried them in hot oil. So las freí en aceite caliente. And finally, finalmente, las puse en un plato. So las is a the direct object pronoun that helps us avoid repetition and make this text more fun. Okay. Now let's read this question. Okay. ¿Preparas la comida con tu madre? Remember, we're talking about family. ¿Preparas la comida con tu madre? What do you say? What will be the pronoun that best? It's the same answer. The difference is this. These guys, the pronoun is always different, see? So which one do you think it is? ¿Preparas la comida con tu madre? Sophie. I'm gonna take her out because it's, well, let's leave her there. So, ¿preparas la comida con tu madre? Sí, la preparo. Sí, la preparo con mi madre. ¿Sirves? Do you serve for refreshments? Sí, los servimos, sí. Prefieren, I'm talking about the family, ¿sí? ¿Prefieren ver la televisión en la noche? Sí, la preferimos ver en la noche. ¿Duermen la siesta todos los días? No, no la dormimos todos los días. So what in the first section, what do you prepare? The food, right? So food goes away and disappears and is to avoid repetition and is replaced with a pronoun in the answer. So, si, la is the direct object that is replacing comida. In the second one, refrescos is the direct object. If you ask, do you serve refreshment? What do you serve? Refreshments. So that's the direct object. So, in the answer to avoid repetition, we use the direct object pronoun. In this case, it's los. So, los servimos con la cena. And the third one, what is it that they prefer to watch? TV, right? So, TV is our direct object. And then it is replaced by the pronoun that matches gender and number of that direct object, which is la. So, si la preferimos ver en la noche. Yes, we prefer to watch it at night. Duermen la siesta. What is it that you sleep? What do you sleep? You sleep the nap. See? So la siesta is the direct object and we replace it with la in the sentence. in the answer. Got it? So direct objects, direct object is that noun that is affected or modified directly by the action. See? And I have for you this other video that I want you guys to see. I wanted to go to the ones in Spanish in this case. Uh-huh. Direct object pronouns. So let's watch them.
A pronoun replaces a noun when the noun has already been mentioned in the conversation. Just as a subject pronoun replaces a noun used as the subject of a verb. A direct object pronoun replaces a noun that functions as a direct object. A noun or pronoun functions as an object when it tells who or what the action of the verb affects. A direct object is one that the verb acts on directly, that is, the effect of the action is felt directly by the direct object. In Spanish, direct object pronouns are different from both subject pronouns and indirect object pronouns. They are me, te, lo, la, nos, os, los, and las.
Okay, so that's what we just did in this exercise. We use la because comida is feminine singular. We use los because refrescos is masculine plural, see? We use la again in la televisión because it's feminine and singular, and that's la, okay? Vámonos. Let's work on this. I want to keep this. But I don't want to close the PowerPoint because I have more for you, chicos. See? Oh, those are. Well, actually, that's it. That's it for now. You guys have in your calendar the assignments for direct objects. See? Let's see, estructuras in this familia and a direct object pronoun. On the exercises, no, Sophie? Sí, ayudas a tus padres. No, llamas a tus padres todos los días. No, no los llamos. Ayudas a tu padre. Who do you help? Tu padre. So, sí. Yo ayudo. I don't want to repeat a mi padre. So, I'm going to replace it with a pronoun. So, I say, sí, yo lo. Ayudo. She gets nervous. Si yo lo ayudo. So I'm going to avoid repetition by you replacing the direct object with the direct object pronoun. He dice, ¿encuentra tu madre tiempo para la familia? Si ella tiempo. Masculine singular, so lo. And I place it before the verb. Si ella lo. En cuenta. Okay? Muy bien, chicos. That's the other thing that I wanted to mention to you is the position. See, the position of the object. And here I have it. See? Direct object goes before the noun. Actually, direct object goes before the verb. Uh-huh, sí. Comes, hablas, let's say, trabajas en el proyecto. So, proyecto is my direct object. No, wait. Haces el proyecto. Haces el proyecto. Sophie, please. Please. ¿Sí? Haces el proyecto. Sí. Proyecto is my direct object. And who does the action? Yo. And I'm going to leave it here. Hago is the action that I do. Sí, yo hago. My direct object is proyecto. And I have to replace it with that pronoun, which is in this case lo. So, si yo lo hago. I do the action, and the action affects proyecto, which comes to be lo in the pronoun. Okay, now I have included everything here. So, let's stop this recording to see what Sophie wants. Okay, have a nice day. And I'm sorry about Sophie's distraction. She's nervous.